Hey Alexa, play Old Town Road by Lil Nas X.
Alexa, play me True Hurts from Lizzo.
Hey Alexa, who did the US women defeat to win the World Cup this year?
Alexa, when's the new Star Wars movie coming out?
Alexa, where can I get a Popeye's chicken sandwich around here?
Is that the plant-based one?
No, I think you're thinking of the Impossible Whopper.
Hey Alexa, what's the Impossible Whopper made of?
You know, just because my name is Alexa does not mean I have to do everything for you. And you know, just because my name is Alexa doesn't mean I know everything.
So you don't know what the Impossible Whopper is made of?
No.
Do you know if there's a Popeyes around here or?
I don't know.
Could you play Old Town Road again?
Sure.
Welcome to Fordham Live, the best of 2019. I'm Natalie Migliori, and I'm joined by my co-host, Jimmy Sullivan.
Natalie, a lot happened this year. I can't wait to break it down with you and the rest of our Fordham Live crew here tonight.
I couldn't have said it better myself, Jimmy. I'm so excited. 2019 has been a chaotic year, and the team has been working hard to highlight some of the top moments.
And Natalie, we'll bring those to you here tonight with the year's best and not so best moments in entertainment, music, sports, and news.
And boy, is there a lot to talk about.
So let's toss it over to our friends John, Rebecca, Nicole, and McGee with a look at 2019 in entertainment.
Hey everyone, welcome to Fordham Live's roundtable of the best entertainment moments of 2019. I'm your host John, and I'm joined here with my co-hosts McGee, Rebecca, and Nicole, and we have a very packed show today. We're going to be talking about the top moments from music, television, film, and popular culture. Are you guys ready to start?
Yeah,
super ready.
Cool. Yeah. So we're going to get started with music. There were some huge songs and albums this year in 2019, and a lot of records were broken, and some of them were broken by music's youngest stars. So we're going to talk about the best music newcomers. Music newcomers this year, you have to mention Lil Nas X and Billie Eilish.
Yes. They both had
huge years. They're both really young. I think Lil Nas X turned 20 this year.
Yeah,
Billie Eilish
so.
Is only 17.
Is she only 17?
Yeah.
Oh my 17. Gosh.
I think she's turning 18 this month. Yeah.
Yep.
Wow. So that yeah, makes they me both had number one songs on the charts this year. Lil Nas X, longest running number one song ever. Billie Eilish was the first artist born in the 2000s to have a number one hit.
Wow.
So it's pretty cool to see artists so young making such big accomplishments.
Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah. I did not know that.
That is great.
Leading into TV, the best choices, I have to choose my number one, Fleabag on Amazon Prime. So, so good. Season two came out this year. Phoebe Waller-Bridge is so brilliant. Good. She won the Emmy.
Yeah.
And it also won, she won the Emmy, and it also won the Emmy for Outstanding Comedy Series.
As it should.
As it should. It's brilliant. And then season two of Big Little Lies on HBO. Oh. All-star cast.
So
cinematography is incredible. I love Laura Dern. I think she's so underrated, but so good.
She really, and speaking of Laura Dern, she's in a new Netflix movie called Marriage Story, and I don't know if you guys have watched it yet.
My mom just watched it. She was like, you need to watch this.
You have
I've been
to
waiting
watch
to watch with friends.
You, yeah. So, I mean, watch with friends, but also be careful because it is very raw. It's super emotional. It's sort of like Manchester by the Sea, where like you only want to watch it once because it's just
heavy.
It's just so it takes on like a lot of topics, like especially around marriage, because you know, we grew up in a time that like everything coming out was like marriage is perfect and woohoo, but it's not, you know, it takes like trials and tribulations to figure it out. So I would definitely check it out. Laura Dern is amazing in it. So good. But you know, we're in award season, so there's that one and The Irishman. So definitely try to check out The Irishman.
Three hours.
I still haven't. Really?
Yeah, you need 3 hours. So I really gotta plan it out.
Yeah, so but, you know, it's Martin Scorsese, so it's gotta be all right. Not that great, but okay.
Well, speaking of relationship problems, one of the biggest moments I think in pop culture this year was the Jordan Woods drama with Jordan Woods, one of the Kardashians, like Kylie's best friend, kissed or potentially more Khloe Kardashian's. Was he her husband then or her boyfriend?
I think boyfriend.
But then also the last thing for this year, the rise of TikTok and that whole thing, which I don't really understand. But coming up, we have Steph's tea time, and she's going to be telling us a little bit more, wrapping up this year as kind of pop culture and summing up everything we've been talking about. So over to Steph.
Hey everybody, welcome back to our final Steph's Tea Time of the semester. I'm Steph, and this week I'm recapping all of 2019. No one is safe. To give some perspective on just how long this year was, let's start with my favorite drama of the year, Jordan Woods cheating with Chloe K's baby daddy, Tristan Thompson. Yes, this happened this year. Honestly, I'm still not sure if this was a publicity stunt, but Jordan and Kylie haven't hung out since, so I'm deciding that it 100% did happen, and Jordan 100% fumbled her sugar baby position with Kylie. Next, my favorite TV show of this year had to be Euphoria. Social media went hard for the show, and so do I. I especially love that psycho, Nate Jacobs. I highly recommend everyone follow the real-life actor, Jacob L. Doherty's IG for some primo thirst traps. My favorite pop culture trend of the year was obviously Hot Girl Summer. Meg Thee Stallion inspired girls and women everywhere to live their best life and do whatever the fuck they wanted this summer, and for that, she is a queen. As 2019 draws to a close, I want to remind everyone that in 2020, you should be staying in your own lane, doing a face mask at least once a week, and voting Donald Trump the fuck out of office. See you girlies next year.
Thanks, Steph, for that 2019 recap of all of the tea from this year. Ton of stuff that I had already forgotten about. I'm glad you reminded me already. Great reminder. We're gonna go ahead and throw it over to Julia now for her last 2019 episode of Jules' Jams. Stay tuned, guys.
Hey everyone, I'm Julia Seabode, and this week we have a special episode of Jules' Jams to help wrap up 2019. The world of music is constantly changing, but here are the top three notable events that happened this year in popular music. First, so many artists came back. Most importantly for me, the Jonas Brothers. If you had told 9-year-old me that I would have been listening to their new music at age 21, I would have fainted. Aside from the Joe Bros, Chance the Rapper released his first album in 3 years, and last week, Coldplay came out with their latest album since 2015. Secondly, I think it's worth noting the connection that music has had to politics this year. I wouldn't necessarily say everything is anti-Trump, rather artists more than ever are working to get their messages and beliefs across. We live in a politically divided time, and popular artists are reacting. From Miley Cyrus's She Is Coming album, to Kanye West releasing a full-fledged gospel album, to Trump mentioning John Legend on Twitter, politics and the music scene are closely connected. Thirdly, and most importantly to me, solo female artists like Billie Eilish, Lizzo, Ariana Grande, and Maggie Rogers became huge this year. I love all of them and the fact that they preach messages such as body positivity and confidence. I definitely think they're being embraced by everyone as their music appeals to young girls as well. Who knows what 2020 will bring, but I'm excited to report the latest music updates with you then on Jules' Jams.
Gracias, Julia, por darnos tus tres mejores momentos del mundo de la música del 2019. Jay, ¿qué crees de su lista?
La música es vida. Music is life.
Tenemos un programa muy divertido preparado para ustedes.
We also have a special segment coming up on why Boston is better than you.
Pero ahora vamos con Sabrina, Dina, Steph y Amanda con sus favorite moments of 2019.
My favorite moment of 2019 would have to be when I went to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disneyland in California, and I got to make my own personal lightsaber. It was green, it looked like Luke Skywalker's. There was a whole like event, Yoda showed up. It was pretty fantastic, and I'm holding onto that lightsaber pretty much until the day I die.
My favorite pop culture moment of 2019 was definitely the college admission scandal with Lori Loughlin. My sisters and I watched a ton of Full House when we were younger, so we really enjoyed seeing all of the memes, including the one where Aunt Becky tries to get her twins into a private preschool. They were all really funny and super ironic. I actually read the transcript for it, and it was super interesting, and I'm interested to see where this case ends up.
My favorite pop culture moment of 2019 is when Kylie Jenner gave us her 5-second hit, Rise and Shine, proving once again that the Kardashians deserve their fame because they are super talented. Also, fun fact, Kim Kardashian had her single, Jam, Turn It Up, which, by the way, Kylie Jenner just blew her out of the water.
My favorite pop culture moment of 2019 had to be the phenomenon surrounding the Fyre Festival at the beginning of this year. Both documentaries on Hulu and Netflix were both interesting and also gave a really good opportunity for viewers to kind of just laugh at rich people crying on an island about getting shitty food that they are kind of just didn't really pay for even. So a lot of great memes also came from it. Really just could not say enough good things about this phenomenon. It was so funny. Big fan.
Hi, I'm Julia from Fordham Live, reminding you that Christmas is right around the corner. Like you need to be reminded, right? So, when it's time to invite friends and family over for a holiday get-together, don't forget to stock the fridge full of J&B's limited edition Yuletide flavor, Rudolph's Rockin' Ruby Red Berry Blast. Even though it's the best time of year, December can also be the most stressed time of the year. So remember to always enjoy it with J&B Soda, the perfect soda for the imperfect world. And here's a quick look at some perfect imperfections brought to you by J&B Soda.
With their new ex-
with
J&B Soda.
I got it right, but then I messed up.
Raspberry.
And a little later after...
As you can see, I'm fit.
Hey everyone, I'm Stephanie Gentle, and I'm...
It's fine. I'm doing fine.
But before we go, we have a special... Special.
I've never said that word like that.
Follow J&B. So, okay. I'm just gonna keep going.
Follow? Oh my god!
I'm redoing that one again.
Hey, everyone.
Damn it.
Okay. Eight. Yep. Eight.
Nah.
I'm forgetting what it is. I missed the last sentence!
Enter.
Sorry.
I'm laughing.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Fordham Live's Best of 2019 Recap Show. If you're just joining us now, you're definitely in the right place. It's crazy to think that 2019 is almost over. What's even more unbelievable is that there's only 1 month left of this entire decade. Soon the 2010s will be over and we'll be on to the very futuristic sounding year of 2020. I think it has a nice ring to it.
I think so too.
But before then, we still have a lot of exciting segments to share with you.
Yeah, we have some great segments coming up, John. There'll be a news breakdown, you'll get to hear some of the cast's New Year's resolutions, and then you'll be getting the year-end edition of Alexa's Zen Corner. I know that one's been highly anticipated.
Sure.
We definitely haven't been short on content this year. I mean, so much has happened.
For sure. But let's throw it now over to Sabrina for the best sports moments of 2019. Sabrina, over to you.
Hey everyone, welcome to Fordham Live Sports. I'm Sabrina Boyd and I'm here with my co-hosts Jimmy Sullivan and Kelly Bright, and we're here to break down the best of sports in 2019. And it is a crazy year for sports, you guys. I don't know about you, but I had a hard time picking some of my favorite moments. So anything from the good, the bad, and to the in-between and just all out strange, let's get to it. So I think the number one thing to talk about has to be the women's national soccer team winning the World Cup. I don't know what you guys felt about that one, but that was a pretty big deal to me. Jimmy, Kelly, any thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, it's their second in a row and fourth of all time, which makes them the winningest country in women's World Cup history. Obviously, it was good for soccer, but it meant a lot more than just sports. I mean, when they won the game 2-0, the last championship game 2-0 over the Netherlands, there was an equal pay chant, and I think that speaks volumes to what Megan Rapinoe and the rest of her team, what their mission was throughout the World Cup.
And you talk about also, like you were saying, how far women's sports has come, and you know, you have now the celebration with the Rapinoe, the infamous goal celebration. So I just thought it was so cool, and we were all invested in that run. I remember watching the final going crazy, kind of biting my nails, but happy we were able to pull it out.
Yeah, me too. I mean, Megan Rapinoe has just become an icon, and she just recently became the Sports Person of the Year in Sports Illustrated, which she's only, I think, the fourth woman mm-hmm. to ever have that title, like standing alone on her own. So that's a pretty big deal. It's meant a lot to soccer. It's meant a lot to just the sports world in general. It's meant, you know, also some of the comments about, you know, going to the White House afterwards. And, you know, a lot of things to take away from the women's soccer victory besides just really excellent soccer being
played. And I thought she handled social media brilliantly, especially with the president. Now, let's talk about someone who didn't handle social media too well this year. Let's talk about Antonio Brown.
Do you have anything to say?
I know
Antonio Brown.
Topic.
Antonio Brown is an embarrassment to the world.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I think.
Couldn't have said it better myself, Jimmy. I mean, it just goes to show you may have the talent, you may be a really great player, but if you don't have the personality and if you don't have that team spirit, if you don't have the character, eventually it's going to come back to bite you. And in this particular case, with just all the drama over a helmet, for all things, all of this with the helmet, more obviously after that, but the helmet of all things is what's the most infuriating to me. I don't know about you guys, but something so ridiculously small and stupid causing such a big blowout, I do not understand what was going on.
It was so dumb, but it's so annoying between the Raiders and the Patriots, but anyway, he blew it.
He really did blow it.
But number three, a guy who did not blow it. Tiger Woods won his first major since 2008 in the Masters in April. Sabrina, you and I were there, not at the Masters, but we were together for this one watching the 18th hole. It was pretty cool.
It was pretty awesome. I will have to say that I've never seen you so excited before. it was tense, nail biting, but I was honestly more watching you than I was watching Tiger Woods. I had confidence he was gonna do all right, but you were worried there for a second. I was concerned I was gonna have to, call public safety. You're gonna have a heart attack.
I mean, it's been a long time coming. The last time he won, LeBron James hadn't won a playoff game, and the top song on the charts was Candy Shop by 50 Cent.
Oh, I remember that one.
Yeah. Do we feel old yet?
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty old right now myself. Well, that's going to do it from us here. Life is a series of hellos and goodbyes. I'm afraid it's time for goodbye again, and now we throw it over to Hannah and Dina.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. I'm Dina.
And I'm Hannah.
And you're watching Fordham Live Best of 2019.
You've just seen Jimmy, Sabrina, and Kelly talk about the best and most talked about moments in sports this year.
And now we're going to throw it over to McGee for a 2019 memoriam honoring those we've lost this year.
We have been having so much fun with this special edition episode of Fordham Live, as 2019 has been a great year for entertainment. However, we want to take the time to remember and pay tribute to some of the personalities we lost this year. Back in July, we lost Disney Channel star Cameron Boyce at just 20 years old. Reports reveal that Cameron died in his sleep from epilepsy while he was home with his family in North Hollywood. Boyce is best known for his roles as Luke Ross on Disney Channel's Jesse and as Carlos in Disney Channel's TV movie, The Descendants. On May 13th, 2019, the world lost Doris Day, one of America's most legendary movie stars and vocalists. Over her career, she appeared in over 36 movies, and many of her songs appeared at the top of the Billboard charts. Day is most well known for her appearances in Pillow Talk and Teacher's Pet, alongside Rock Hudson and Clark Gable. She was also an outspoken animal activist and funded her own nonprofit organization, the Doris Day Animal League. She was 97. Back in March, legendary rap artist, entrepreneur, and activist Nipsey Hussle died at the age of 33. He was shot in front of his own store, Marathon Clothing, allegedly, by Eric Holder after an apparent argument. Nipsey was known not only as a Grammy-nominated rapper, but as a pillar for his community. After leaving the Roland 60s Crips, a Los Angeles-based gang, he made it his mission to give back to his community. Nipsey funded upgrades to school playgrounds, invested in real estate, and gave jobs to struggling neighbors in his native Crenshaw. His legacy will not be forgotten. Fordham Live remembers those that have passed in 2019. We will not lose sight of their contributions to the world and to the industry. Now over to Natalie, Steph, and Hannah, who will be discussing the top news moments of 2019.
Welcome to Fordham Live's Best of 2019 Top News Moments. I'm Natalie Migliori, and joining me is Steph Gentle and Hannah Crean. So we're going to tell you the top news moments, in our opinions, of 2019. Steph, why don't you tell us what's up?
I think something that really, really excited me this year, because I'm a space nerd, I love anything that happens to do with NASA, space, aliens, all of it. China accomplished the first landing on the far side of the moon this past January. Right at the beginning of the year, it was January 3rd. And I just think it was so cool because we've never really been to that side of the moon. And obviously, I think just I would love to go to the moon one day. So props to China for doing this. I think it was just really interesting to read about and see, what they're doing up there.
From one aircraft to the other, the MAX 737, the Boeing MAX 737 crashed, causing all models of the plane to be grounded. That was a big Ethiopian Airlines flight that crashed in March. And the company has been battling with that for a really long time.
Well, I feel like they probably should keep battling because they're obviously doing something wrong. It's not great.
Nose dives are not good.
Not good.
Yeah, and they're still talking about it. They're still grounded. Some airlines are trying to bring them back, but I'm not sure I would fly them. But a little bit darker, 50 people were killed in a terror attack in New Zealand after a gunman opened fire in a mosque in Christchurch. But 6 days later, New Zealand passed a sweeping ban on semi-automatic assault rifles, literally just 6 days later, which is incredible. Wish we could do something like that in the United States, but not in America. Someday.
Taking
maybe
action
someday.
Right away, yeah, saw some action on that. Yeah, and definitely I think, on another level, wildfires have been raging in California. We hear that all the time. But one artist named Jesse Mercer actually collected 1,400 keys from destroyed churches, schools, and everything else within the raging California fires, and made a metal phoenix sculpture, which is amazing, out of all their keys.
I saw that, actually. That was super sick.
Yeah,
super amazing. Cool. I think kind of going along the ban in New Zealand on gun rifles, on automatic weapons, in 2019, Juuls have now been banned in America before the sale of automatic weapons. So several states, municipal cities have participated in the ban: San Francisco, Mass, Michigan, Montana, New York, Rhode Island, and Washington. I don't know what you guys think about this. I think, yeah, it's good for health reasons, but I think it just shows that we can really ban anything in this country. Why aren't we banning guns and the more important things?
I think it'll be interesting to see what ban comes next, but that is all the time we have, and those are the top news moments from 2019. But up next, Fordham Live's on-air staff will offer up their New Year's resolutions.
So I usually don't make New Year's resolutions because I don't stick to them and I don't really believe in them, but if I had to make one for next year, I'm going to say I won't procrastinate, but I mean that in the loosest way possible. So instead of doing things the night before they're due, I'll do them 2 nights before they're due because it takes a little bit of the pressure off. And you know, baby steps are important. I'm not going to say I'm going to do it like a week before because I'm not going to lie to myself. So we'll see how this works out.
So my New Year's resolution for 2020, and to be honest with you guys, I don't really believe in New Year's resolutions, but if I were to have one, I would say to take care of myself physically and mentally. I didn't do a good enough job of that in 2019. But more than anything, I just love giving out great advice that I will never ever heed. So all of you should do it, but as for me, I'm probably gonna pass. So that's my advice to you.
My 2020 New Year's resolution is to continue doing what works for me. Not only do I continue to work hard to maintain a fit body, but I also continue to work hard to maintain a fit mind.
My New Year's resolution is to be meaner. Weird, right? But I've had multiple people tell me that I'm too nice this year, so look out 2020, I'ma be a bitch. Is that too much?
Hello everyone, and welcome to this year-end edition of Alexa Zen Corner, the show where we talk about anything and everything self-care. Today, I will be sharing 5 simple practices for a happier 2020. The first practice that you can try is gratitude journaling. Just spending 10 to 15 minutes a day writing down the things for which you're thankful can increase happiness. The second practice is, you guessed it, meditation. Reserving 10 to 30 minutes of your day for meditation will help improve your overall well-being. The third practice involves getting your blood pumping through exercise. The release of endorphins through exercise can help improve both your mental and physical health. The fourth practice is to remove toxic people from your life. Make the new year an opportunity to distance yourself from people who tear you down and focus on the relationships that uplift you. The final practice is to declutter. Through getting rid of the items that you don't need, you can bring more order to your life and free your mind. Thank you so much for joining me for this special episode of Alexa Zen Corner. Remember to take a deep breath and namaste.
I'm Hannah.
And I'm Kelly.
We have to head to a break, but first, we're gonna give a little love to Boston.
I mean, not only is it the city of champions, with the Patriots, the Red Sox, the Celtics, and the Bruins, they also serve a wicked clam chowder. Nothing like you've ever tasted before, nothing like you're gonna get anywhere else. And this year, they were ranked the second sexiest accent in America, second only to Texas. And who really cares about Texas?
No one. Exactly, Kelly. I mean, it's home to Tom Brady and Fenway Park, the oldest stadium in the MLB. Can't find that anywhere else. And I mean, it does everything better than everyone. From lobster rolls to the clam chowder to sports to producing beautiful humans like Tom Brady and talented humans like Tom Brady, Matt Damon, Ben Affleck, Rob Gronkowski. I mean, seriously.
I mean, Larry Bird, Bill Russell, the list goes on, Bobby Orr. I wish we could talk about this all day, but we kind of can't. We still got a lot more show left to go, and you're not going to want to miss it. Stay tuned. Fordham Live will be right back. This is kind of a hot button issue, but I gotta bring it up. How do you feel about Swiffers?
I want you to describe the perfect first date.
This young man over here is about to be matched up with none other than Molly the Mop.
Do you usually pick up Legos?
What do your parents think about Molly?
What makes you think this time's gonna be different, Jared?
I mean, that's a choice, I guess. That awkward interaction, thank God I wasn't there.
So what are your upcoming thoughts?
Ah, yes, totally.
He's concerned.
How would you feel about this newfound fame in Casas?
Jerry, how are you?
Oh, you do? Are you at all concerned about the vacuums, the new boy band?
Let us know. How did this relationship with you and Dr. Phil start?
I did see the robots.
I was at Walmart and the robot came and it was just brooming and mopping at the same time. Where's the mop at? Talk to me.
As 2019 comes to an end, so does my second to last semester of college. That means I'll have to be an adult soon. But I'm kind of already on my way there, like my patience has begun to run thin a little bit and the rate at which I lose my shit is increasing exponentially. I don't have a job though, but my degree in philosophy is making sure I don't ever get one. Also, I am a comedian, which is technically a job, or as my mother likes to call it, a waste of everybody's time. I do not have any money, no, but I do want to be rich at some point in my life. I'm not worried about it because, as my favorite philosopher Lil Wayne says, I'm on the road to riches, it's just a little traffic. Hopefully I'll get there in 2020. And now I'm going to throw it over to Tanya for her best soccer moments of 2019.
Good evening everyone, you know what time it is. For weeks you've heard me insult teams, attack FIFA, and even rant about players' haircuts. However, this episode is going to be a little different. Welcome to the special year-end edition of Tanya's Soccer Recap. We have a whole year of soccer news to cover and not a lot of time to do it, so let's get right into it. The United States earned their fourth Women's World Cup title this summer after defeating the Netherlands 3-1. This summer's Women's World Cup also had a combined 1.12 billion viewers who watched the games, a record audience for the competition. Other tournaments also took place this summer, such as Copa America. The most important thing to happen there was Messi accusing FIFA of corruption. He wasn't wrong, but of course he was forced to issue an apology by the Argentine Football Association, banned from playing with his national team for 3 months, and fined $50,000, which is pocket change for him, let's be honest. Soccer also got some new rules this year. Players who are being substituted must now exit the field at the closest point on the touchline. This is an attempt to not allow players to waste time by taking forever to walk to the halfway line, and I'm cool with it. Another rule allows the ref to give coaches yellow and red cards if they're being difficult or just downright annoying. I know I missed a lot of stuff, but I would need a whole other year to cover everything from this year, and it isn't even over yet. Thank you so much for tuning into my soccer recap. I'm Tania Perez, and I'll see you next time.
Someone who I thought was a great positive influence this year was actress Jameela Jamil, best known for her role in Netflix's series The Good Place. I thought she was a great role model because she focused on moving conversations away from actresses' bodies and focusing on their abilities. But she also recognized her own privilege and that the conversation shouldn't just be controlled by her, but should be an open conversation between all of us.
Another individual who I think positively shaped 2019 would have to be Iron Man himself, Robert Downey Jr. I don't think anybody could think of 2019 without thinking about the impact of Avengers Endgame, now the highest grossing movie of all time. Robert Downey Jr.'s final portrayal of Iron Man was definitely bittersweet, but I think it's something that moviegoers will be thinking about for a long time.
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. Come on, you know the song, and you probably know the artist too, Lil Nas X. At just 20 years old, he now holds the record for longest number one hit single with Old Town Road. He's also the first artist to come out as openly gay while his song is number one on the charts. He blends boundaries, reinvents genres, posts fire tweets on Twitter, and stays 100% true to himself. A true icon for 2019.
Someone who I think definitely positively influenced 2019 is James Holzhauser from Jeopardy. He won over $2 million during his 32-day streak, and he's so smart, and he just knew so many questions, and he was really inspiring to watch. I can't wait to see him during the Tournament of Champions in January. Hopefully he'll win again.
At the age of 16, climate change activist Greta Thunberg has confronted governments and corporations, urging for an immediate response to the climate change crisis. Her UN summit speech was incredibly impassioned, reminding us of the importance of including young voices in conversations for change.
Hey everyone, it's Sabrina Boyd. As 2019 comes to a close, it's important to take a moment and reflect on the past 343 days. If I had to sum up the year in one phrase, I'd settle on a beautiful dumpster fire. Now, before you start thinking that the holiday stress has already gotten to my head, I'm well aware that this does not make sense, but neither did 2019. It was a crazy combination of really amazing and really terrible moments that blended together in a sort of paradoxical, awe-inspiring monstrosity that we are both simultaneously disgusted by and fond of. I mean, on one hand, we had Donald Trump and the entirety of his administration still somehow remain in office, but we also saw the most diverse class of lawmakers in history get sworn in as part of the 116th Congress. California was continuously on fire and the weather has hit all kinds of crazy extremes, but a new climate change hero, Greta Thunberg, swept onto the scene with a disapproving stare down for the ages. and party politics and a steady increase in polarization shows a deeply divided America, but we managed to unite where it really counts, keeping Betty White alive for another whole year. 2019 was a year to recognize and embrace our messiness, and another marker in the continual quest to balance out the good with the bad. So, here's to 2019, and who knows, maybe in 2020 we'll see a little more beautiful and a little less dumpster fire.
All right, everyone. Unfortunately, our wonderful show is coming to a close and we must say goodbye.
Yes, a great show indeed. It really captured the best and the not so glamorous of 2019.
We have loved bringing you up to date on all things pop culture, sports, and more.
Be sure to tune into Fordham Live for an all new season next month. We promise to keep bringing you the goods.
Come on, everyone. I hope to see you all around. I'm Nicole Langford.
And I'm Natalie Migliori. Thanks for joining us for Fordham Live, the best of 2019.
Bye!
Happy holidays! Thank you for everything! Woo!
A happy new year, everybody. A very happy new year.